Hello and welcome to St. John's for this short organ recital. In this time that we've been unable to be together in person for our services, several parishioners have contacted me and asked if it would be possible to hear the organ virtually because they've missed hearing the instrument in church. And this is something that I'm very happy to do. This instrument that we are fortunate enough to have is an extraordinary instrument in that it's capable of great power and great subtlety. And so across the five pieces that I'm going to play, I hope I'll be able to demonstrate some of that range. Just a word about the pieces before I begin to play. Starting with the Imperial March of Sir Edward Elgar. This is a piece you may well know. It was written in 1897 for Queen Victoria's Diamond Jubilee. And Elgar was asked to write this piece for the occasion, originally for orchestra, and it was arranged later for organ by Sir George Martin. And this is one of the pieces that demonstrates the full range of the organ's dynamics. It's often then said that no organ recital is complete without a piece by J.S. Bach, who is widely considered the father of all organ music. His output was enormous. He lived from 1685 to 1750, and among this vast output of music were some chorale preludes based on the hymns of the Lutheran Church. And the way that it worked in Bach's day was that very often an improvisation would be played on the organ before the congregation sang the hymn as a way of introducing that piece of music. And so I'm going to play the chorale prelude Liebste Jesu, which translated is Blessed Jesu, we are here. This shows off some of the organ's far gentler colors. Then to England and the music of Ralph Vaughan Williams, one of England's foremost composers, and his setting of Rosimedra, which is a Welsh hymn tune, sometimes sung to the hymn My Song is Love Unknown. We don't sing it to that tune these days so much. We usually sing it to the tune by called Love Unknown by John Ireland. But nonetheless, this setting of Vaughan Williams is very effective indeed. Staying then in England and the music of Percy Whitlock. Whitlock was a resident of Bournemouth on the south coast of England, where all the best people grew up, and was organist of St. Stephen's Church, a very Anglo-Catholic, spiky church, and the Pavilion Theatre in Bournemouth. And you can see the influence of Whitlock's theatre music in his church organ music, and vice versa. He had an enormous span and had a double joint, I think, in his left hand, and so could span the interval of a tenth with no problem whatsoever. So it makes some of his music a bit challenging to play. But I'm going to play his folk tune from five short pieces, which again shows off some of the very sensitive sounds of the instrument. The final piece is David N. Johnson's trumpet tune in A major. David N. Johnson, an American composer, prolific composer, wrote a number of trumpet tunes in various keys, all of them very evocative, very, very effective. And this one in the key of A shows off the Imperial trumpet, which is just out of your sight line, but is the big copper trumpet high up here on the wall, and is, I think, a fitting piece with which to finish. Before I do, I would like to thank John Edgar, our parish administrator, for his expertise in recording and videoing, as well as his willingness to flip a page or two in a couple of the pieces where I'm a bit busy to be able to do it myself. So thank you for joining us. I very much hope you enjoy the program, and wherever you are, stay well and stay safe.